extend a curtsy to the king's son. He handed her the golden slipper and sat down on a footstool, took her foot out of her heavy wooden shoe, and put it into the slipper. It fitted perfectly.
1144.
And when she stood up and the king's son looked into her face, he recognized the beautiful girl he had danced with and cried out, "This is my true bride." The stepmother and the two sisters went pale with fear and rage. But he lifted Ashpuddle up on his horse and rode away with her. As they passed the hazel tree, the two white doves called out, "Woo-coo! Woo-coo! No blood in the shoe. Her foot is neither long nor wide. This one is the proper bride." Then they flew down and alighted on Ashpuddle's shoulders, one on the right and one on the left, and there they sat. On the day of Ashpuddle's wedding, the two stepsisters came and tried to ingratiate themselves and share in her happiness. On the way to church, the elder was on the right side of the bridal couple and the younger on the left. The doves came along and pecked out one of the elder sister's eyes and one of the younger sister's eyes.
Seriously?
Afterward, on the way out, the elder was on the left side and the younger on the right, and the doves pecked out the remaining eyes. So both sisters were punished with blindness to the end of their days for being so wicked and false.
Now, one of the things that makes Grimm's fairy tales sometimes not so popularly read today, you can guess, is the violence of the text. Notice here we're cutting off toes, we're cutting off heels, we got eyes being pecked out by doves. Of course, again, the idea here is that virtue and goodness and purity are rewarded. Meanness, vileness is going to be punished, right? All right, let's jump to 2A really quickly. What for you is the major messages here of a text like this? Some have argued this is the great text of revenge in the end. Ashpuddle is able to get revenge on the two mean, wicked stepsisters by patience, right? By patience. Notice another major message here is that for love to ever find its way, there has to be a series of tests, a series of challenges, we might say, at 2B. Well, obviously, we've got the archetypical kinds of things, patterns happening here. And of course, this one a little bit more for you easier because you know the Cinderella motif, so you kind of knew what happened. Although, notice some of the violence that you might want to jot down at 2B is a little bit surprising here. Obviously, we're not going to put this in a Disney version film for a bunch of children, right? At 3A, obviously, we've mentioned Cinderella. Obviously, we could mention lots of other titles. But I want you to write down at 3A the ways in which you see some remarkable similarities between this text and Psyche and Cupid. Of course, notice that Psyche's sisters, ultimately, they get jacked. They actually end up dead. Notice in this story, they just end up blind. But for sure, we've got that happening. And of course, ultimately, we have the true love conquers all motif, no doubt. Finally, at 3B, what do you want to say about a story like this? And more particularly, the violence of a story like this. Do you think of this as a children's story? I've had sophomores that say, this is really not a story probably that should be shared. The Cinderella story is a whole lot safer. But I want to ask this question at 3B. What are your thoughts about a story like this in regards to the idea that love will ultimately find its way and you have to work hard to overcome challenges? For example, when was the last time in your life that you had to work hard to overcome some tasks or challenges that were clearly unfair? You were being given challenges. They were not fair, that was the way you were being treated, and yet somehow you were able to figure it out, work through it, and ultimately get what you deserved. Of course, when was a time that maybe your enemy got jacked in some way, in the same way that this story happened? Well, there you go, an introduction to Ashpuddle. Pretty gross, right? So you're a little bit freaked out by this one. Seriously? Well, now you know a little bit more about Brothers Grimm. Thank you.